This is Bella Barracks freestyle from the underwater camera angle. This is Coach Connor commentating. We'll be viewing this video at 1/4 the original speed it was recorded at for video analysis purposes. Let's begin. Okay, Bella, kind of picking up where we left off on the above water video. And if you haven't watched the above water video, please go back and review that. Where we left off was the big thing was on the head position and the breathing. Okay, your head position is great on the swim. As we can see here, okay, eyes are down, arms extended out in front, okay, but I can tell you're about to breathe because the arm is already beginning to drop, okay, and I can see the head starting to lift up. The head's lifting up, the arm is dropping, okay, and then our hips eventually drop too, because what happens is, you've got one arm down, one arm up to the ceiling. If you remember, if you recall from the above water video, your arm is coming over, okay, as the other arm is pulling down under. So you have one arm up, one arm down, and as you notice, as you finish pulling through, your hips drop. Your hips drop. It's slight, but it's enough to cause a disturbance. So you go from hips at the surface to hips well below the surface. Okay, you go from about being right at the surface to being about 5 to 6 inches below the surface, which doesn't sound like much, but in swimming, those inches matter and those details add up. Okay, then let's pay attention to the crossover, because that breath is so large, okay, and we're taking it for quite a long time. This is what we're talking about in the crossover in the above water video. As you can see, you're crossing over the center line of the body. That's causing a lot of resistance. We want to make sure every stroke that we take, okay, is extending out in front, okay, and then pulling past our hips, okay, directly through. We don't want to go out, around, and in. We want to extend out and pull through every single time. Okay, and that arm position stems from the head position. Look at your stroke with the head down. Now, let's go back. Again, look at your body position when your eyes are down. Okay, your head could be a little more relaxed still, but comparing it to your breathing strokes, it is so much better. Look at that. That's excellent body position. Arms are fully extended. The hands are pushing past the hips. Moment we go to take that breath, you can already see your lead arm is dropping way more than it normally would on a stroke that you're not breathing on. It's because we're setting up or lifting up that head. Okay, and it's causing the hips to drop. I know I keep sounding like a broken record, but I really want you to understand this concept because it's very important to your freestyle and making it faster. Okay, again, here's a really good shot in terms of what we were talking about. You can see that arm is extending up, okay, to the ceiling while the other one is down towards the bottom. Okay, and again, pay attention to your hips as you pull through, how they drop down. They drop down well below the surface as compared to back here where the hips are up at the surface. Okay, again, right before your breath, hips are up at the surface. Up at the surface, go to take that big breath, hips drop just enough, and then you can see right there. And now we go back up, so it's kind of an up and down motion. And in freestyle, we want to go from side to side. We don't want to be going up and down in freestyle, side to side. Okay, so again, just timing on the stroke, on the breath, head position on the breath. Okay, it all goes together. Every single detail matters, as I say in practice. All the little details make a big difference, okay? I think everything is there in order to have a great freestyle, okay? It's just learning. If we can learn to just time that breath properly, keep it low, keep it tight, that stroke is going to come around a lot better, okay? Next video we're going to view is the flip turn video.